Hello guys, myself Asta Patel. Today I am going to teach you about the adult learning. Adult learning is one of the subtypes of in-service education. So guys, let's see about the adult learning. Adult education is a formal and informal system of education for older and a mature person. So this adult learning, or we can say education, is only provided to the adults because they are older and having the maturity in their age. We are providing formal as well as informal education in the adult learning. It is carried out on a part-time basis and entirely voluntary. So we are carried out, or we are going to teach the adult on a part-time basis, and it is up to them to choose the adult learning or not. We are not forcing anybody to join the adult education. It is totally voluntary process. It involves conscious efforts towards developing the individual capabilities of adult by public or private agencies through informational, cultural, remedial, vocational, recreational and professional methods. So we are making the adult to develop their knowledge and skills in the area of information, culture, remedial, vocational, recreational as well as professional. These adult education agencies are either public agencies or private agencies. Which one are chosen by adult, that is up to them. If they want to get education from the public agency, they can go for that. If they want to learn in a private agency, they can go for that. But the overall aim of that both the agency, public and private, is provide the education related to information, culture, remedial, vocational, recreational and a professional. Purpose of adult education. First, we will see the individual point of view about the adult education. First one is a remedial. So, it provides education to those adults who could not receive education because of certain reason. So, remedial classes or a remedial education we are providing to those adults who did not get any previous education because of certain reason, either it will be a poverty or anything. Development of physical health. So it aim at educating the adult in the fundamental principles of health for prevention of disease. So this is also a type of health education the nursing students are giving to the community area, to the adult people, for the prevention of the disease. So the aim of physical health education is to provide the basic information to the adults about how they can take care of their health as well as how they can prevent the disease. Third one is a vocational development. So vocational development, that means particular to one department or one occupations. So in the adult education, they are providing training for particular his or her vocation. Suppose we can take the example, if one family is poor and their main occupation is tailoring. So the ladies of that family are getting the training of tailoring from this public or private agency of adult education. So that is a vocational development of that vocation, of their occupation. They are providing the further training to the adults. Then development of social skills. It aims at training the adult for social living, to teach them the sense of rights and duties and live in harmony with their colleagues. So social skills are dealing with, we are awareing the adults about what are the human rights and what are their roles and responsibility to live in a community. So social skills are dealing with the rights of humans, then what are the roles and responsibility of adults in their community, and how they can maintain their relationships with their colleagues as well as neighbors, as well as with their family members. That all kind of skills are taught by the adult education under the development of social skills. Another one is a self-development. It aims at training creative faculties of the adult for their self-development. So self-development, that means they are providing the training to enhance their self-confidence, and ultimately that may increase their self-development. Recreational aim. It aims at training the adults for the best use of leisure with a proper recreation. So in the recreational aim, they are teaching the adults how they can utilize their time in their leisure periods with the help of recreation. Next topic is needs of adult education. Adult education is required for the individual to get the satisfactions of their needs. It is provided for a further education and to enlarge their cultural horizons. It provided for healthy recreation and relaxation, which is provided by a properly planned program of social education. To make the adults more politically aware and participate in a civic activities. To become more socially efficient and develop the spirit of cooperation between the family members, neighbors and their colleagues. And for the economical betterment and self-sufficiency, we are providing adult education. Another thing is organization of adult education. So first, if we want to organize adult education at the village level, what things we have? So in the village level, the youth clubs and Mahila Mandals are organized for this purpose. So there are several kind of youth clubs are there. The adults of same age group are gathering monthly, one time or twice, and they can share their ideas and views. Same for the ladies or for the females, they are having the Mahila Mandals to having the adult education. In village, panchayat secretary of cooperative society, if any, primary school teacher should combine their efforts. So the village panchayat, the cooperative secretary, primary school teachers, these all are the people who are responsible to provide the adult education to the adults of their village. Then another one is a block level. There should be full-time officers at the block level, one man and one woman, to provide the adult education. Another one is a district level. Every district social education officer to supervise the work of all social education officers, both male and a female. So in a district level, there is a one appointed one district social education officer. And what is the roles and responsibility of that officer is, that officer is supervising the work of all social education officer. Those who are providing social education to both males and females, they are supervised by the district social education officer. Next one is a state level. So in a state, there is a joint or a deputy director at the state level to look after the administration of all aspects of adult education. So the state level officer are joint or deputy director. So this person is responsible to look after the all the administrative activities which are done under their states and whatever activities are done in their states or districts. Last one is the central level. So Ministry of Education is in charge of all the programs of adult education. So at the central level, there will be a Ministry of Education who is in charge of all the adult education, all the adult learning activity which are running in the whole countries. So all these programs implemented by central scheme of through state education department. So this adult education or adult learning, this all is implemented by the central scheme through the state education department. Then materials for adult education. So whatever material is provided to the adults for their learning. So first one is a reading material. So the department is providing books and pamphlets, daily newspapers, and periodically they are providing the journal or any magazines on a monthly or a weekly basis. From the reading material, they can get the knowledge about particular topic. Then the audio visual materials. The main aviates used are blackboards, bulletin boards, film, charts, graphs, and maps were also used for adult education. Methods of teaching the adults. So first method is learner dominated approach. So in the learner dominated approach, the first method is trial and error method. The learner concentrates his efforts by repeating an activity a number of times and acquire the skills. So the learner are keep trying or doing the things or doing the activity, and from the mistakes of that particular activity, the learner are getting knowledge and try to solve that method. So this is a trial and error method. Individual investigation method, in that it involves thinking or a learning by insight supplemented by use of library, use of laboratory, survey and a field trips. So individual investigation method, that means the learner himself are thinking or developing his or her insight, which is given or supplemented by the laboratory, survey and field trips. The third one is a project method. So project method is a combination of the trial and error method and individual investigation method. So it combines first two methods. And the second type is teacher dominated methods. So in the teacher dominated methods, the first one is a lecture method, another one is a counseling, then casework. In that, teacher goes into the history of an individual cases and teaches him the way to lead happy and satisfied life. Then demonstration and cooperative methods like group discussions. Then agencies of adult education. So which all are the agencies in our country that are providing adult education? In that, classes of people like teachers, government servants, volunteers, social education worker. Then second one is regular educational institutions like school, colleges, universities, libraries and community centers. So these all are the places from where the adult can get the learning or educations. Then informal education devices like forums, study circles, discussion groups, listening groups and camps. Another one is the recreational education bodies like theaters. And last is institutions whose primary function is not education, then religious bodies. Now problems of adult education. So if there is no cooperation from adults, we cannot able to provide the education to them. Problems of social education worker. So if the workers, those who are providing the educations, are not able to provide the learning to the adults, or they are not willing to provide any education to that adults, so or any health issue of that worker or any language barrier, so that will be the problems of social education worker. Then problems of attendance. Another one is a problem of vocational trainings, problems of equipment, problems of social backwardness, problems of suitable literature and problem of finance. So because of all these functions, we are not able to provide adult education. I hope you like my video. Thank you so much for viewing my video. Thank you.